Everyone chooses an object, say your choice out loud to the rest of the players before clicking. Before clicking now, or?
Yeah, you have to say it before, and everyone then... Everyone chooses an object, you say it out loud, and then once you've chosen it, you say it, and then you hit it.
Any object?
So, Pat.
Pat?
No, hat.
Oh, hat.
Yeah.
Hat, Pat.
Do we want to get specific on hats?
Okay. I will say drum, because everything's a drum.
Mike.
Player orders decide on based on how unsexy it would be to have the selected object as a sexual toy.
Well, I mean, that mic is pretty round.
Well...
I mean, that's probably the most sexy one.
That's true, yeah.
And drum?
Hats, striptease is the only thing I can think about it.
I mean, unless you want to fold it and, like, try to cram it in somewhere, like, yeah.
You have to do some full dangling with that one. And drum?
Just smacking it. Just pounding it. Just pounding it.
Use your butt to hit.
Yeah, that's fair.
Well, I do think that you are the sexiest.
Yeah,
so.
Cam, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
You decide between us then. Which is sexier, a hat or a drum? Hat or drums?
I would say it would go hat, then drum.
Okay. I mean, could you also use the hat for, like, a surprise?
Yeah.
Surprise! It's like that dick in a box. Like, surprise, it's my dick! No. All
right, then you start.
I get to pick first?
You get to pick first, because you were the sexiest. Mm-hmm. The table you chose is quite crowded. Liam sits across from Miranda, who's flanked by two well-dressed servants. I thought that said arst.
Well, arst.
One of the servants cuts a slice of Salisbury steaks and feeds it to the other. Okay. Seriously, Miranda? You have servants chew your food for you?
What? Of course not. That would be barbaric.
The servant happily swallows the Salisbury steak.
I have servants eat for me. They're called eating serfs. Don't you have any?
First of all, no. I don't eat food. Second of all, that totally defeats the purpose of eating. Aren't you worried about starving?
Why would I be? My serfs get all the calories I need to stay fit and healthy.
I have no objective reason to care about this. But suddenly, it's all I care about. Someone convince Miranda she has to stop this madness.
Maybe you should start this madness, Liam. Imagine all the food you could Instagram without having to eat it, any of it. Miranda, look at the
contented
smile on that servant's face. You think he's eating for you, but secretly he's eating for himself.
You might have a point there. For too long, I've been needlessly ordered off the cafeteria menu, leaving my food untouched even as I take the most artistic grams. I justified the wastefulness by the intense artistic merits of my photographs, that's how us cool people say it, but I need compromise no longer. Finally, I can have my cake and pay someone else to eat it for me too. Still, Miranda, this makes way less sense for someone who actually needs to eat to survive.
Oh, you're just jealous of how cute my serfs are. Eat up, little guys. I'm not fooling.
Seriously, how does Miranda keep from starving to death? Do they put an IV in her while she sleeps? Whatever, she's happy. Alright, Yella.
Shadows.
Alright.
Who dat
person?
You buy items from.
Yeah, she's like the shopkeeper or whatever.
Okay. Is that kind of like the drink cat in the other one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and then this table over here, she's like the monster hunter.
Okay.
So, and you technically can romance her, but it takes a little bit more.
Yeah.
I think just in the longer runs, I believe, but...
You arrive at your chosen table, to find Damien dejectedly hefting a ball of mashed potato, while Polly sadly passes her hand through the same.
Seriously, what do we have to do to get a food fight starting in this cafeteria? I honestly do not know. I tried throwing potatoes at people and yelling food fight, but I think everyone is too scared for me to fight back. And I can't throw any food because of my stupid ghost hands. Plates, mirrors, antique furniture, sure, but not food. There's gotta be a way to provoke a food fight. My dads are always telling me to be more political. But we're not political. Your strength is hitting things, and my strength is being unbelievably hot all the time.
Correct.
Unbelievably hot? That's it! We set the cafeteria on fire! Wait, no, that's not a solution. That's just arson. Why do I always jump straight to arson?
It's hard to watch them struggle through this by themselves, so you step in with an idea of your own.
Wars are fought over scarce resources. Steal everybody's food and put it in a pile. That ought to do it. Hey, Polly, you know how the Greeks fought a whole war over Helen of Troy's face? We just need you to get kidnapped by Detroit. No, I like this one. Yeah. I like where your head is, but I'm not sure. I'm not super into being kidnapped and shit. What if we skip some steps and get to the good old Flash?
Polly floats off the table in a practice motion and whips her top off.
Whoa! To the victor!
This is a high school cafeteria. Polly's rash action upsets the roiling cauldron of hormones, sets it on fire, and tap dances on the ruins. Soon the air is thick with sausage and gravy, if you know what I mean. Potato crisps flying everywhere like flavored shrapnel. Polly puts her shirt on, and now that everyone's too busy fighting to remember what they're fighting about...
Looks like mine were really the tits that launched a thousand chips.
The view you just got makes that pun work.
I love that.
Beautiful.
That's wonderful.
Beautiful.
All right, well, I guess...
love me some history jokes, man.
All right, well, I guess I'll get something at the cat. I've got 5 monies. But I don't know what I'm going to need. No, this one did.
But yeah, it's still your table.
Alright, well, I guess I'll sit with Miranda and the Magnus.
The Magnus.
Vera's drinking her customary lunchtime scotch, because you can drink whatever the hell you want at this school, but Scott's not making it easy for her. You be Magnus.
Hey, Vera. What you drinking?
What?
Scotch, why?
Because it smells like a delicious forest fire, and I'm curious. What's it called?
Scotch.
Yes?
No, that's what it's called.
What?
Scotch.
Oh, I see what's going on.
Who's on first?
Yeah. Yes?
No, I'm not saying your name. I'm saying the name of the drink that I'm drinking. It's scotch.
It's mine.
No, it's mine.
That's what it's called, Scots.
That's just what it's called.
Oh, it's like an energy drink for Scots.
I mean, it's like an energy drink for Scottish people.
Hey, I'm a Scottish person. I'm as Scottish as it's possible to be. I'm the most Scot.
Now, what will it take to get you to drop this issue? Scott's not going to drop it unless you do something, so you cut in and say... yeah, it's called Scott's, but today it's opposite day, so everything that's Scott's is actually Vera's. You're right, Scott, that drink is your birthright. Chug, chug, chug. I say opposite day. Yay!
Don't you mean today isn't opposite day?
No.
Oh, ha. I'm not sorry. Not Vera. I guess I'll be taking your drink. Wink. Wait. Time out. If everything's that Scott is, Vera's, do I have to give Vera all my stuff?
Yes.
Okay, and does Vera have to give me all her stuff?
Sure. Unfortunately for you, I have no stuff. All my possessions are owned by cleverly disguised shell companies. Now hand over your wallet.
Okay, boy, Officer Day sure is the best, isn't it?
I love this dumb, thick
man.
Oh,
yeah, he's the best, funny. Yeah.
It sure is. After Scott leaves you alone, you and Vera definitely don't spend all of his money on cocaine. What is with all the cocaine in this frickin'...
This is a great fucking high school, come on.
Let's trade places. Everyone chooses a brand. Say your choice out loud to the rest of the players before clicking.
A brand?
Lagavulin whiskey.
Fuck.
That was yours.
No. My brain is not set up for brands.
Tetley tea.
Tetley.
Yeah.
Versace, I don't know.
Versace, all right. Player order decided on how weird it would be if the selected brand paid for a product placement in Game of Thrones. Start debating now. I guess Versace, hey?
Kind of, right?
All right, and then I guess Tetley second, because Lagavulin would fit in Game of Thrones. I'm always last.
Technically,
shit.
So would tea.
Yeah, I know, but it's slightly less. So
I suppose, yeah.
Alcohol fits in Game of Thrones better than tea.
That's true. That's a true story. yeah, let's go.
It's Scott's.
It's Scott's, yes.
That day, an epic dodgeball match takes place. Everything seems lost, but you deliver an inspirational speech that fuels your team's spirits, leading to a spectacular comeback. You are clearly a natural-born leader. You gain 2 charm.
Nice.
You're just getting ready to leave when you get a text from Polly. Hey, BB Liz Parley. How can you refuse such a formal missive? You track her down immediately.
Hey, you got my text? That's good, because I need some help brainstorming. I'm going to a party tonight, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be lame, and that needs to change. See, it's a costume party, you know, where everyone dresses up as their favorite humans. I'm going as a sexy tax attorney.
Yes!
But I'm not sure even the sexiest tax attorney can rescue this party from the depths of lamitude. So, got any ideas to help spice things up?
You've got some ideas, and they're the spiciest.
Spike the punch with mandrake root. It turns monsters into actual humans. Okay, you go as a sexy tax attorney, and I'll go as a sexy tax evader.
I think that's the answer.
Oh, no.
Aw, beans.
Later that night, you're hanging out at the party, waiting for Polly, wearing a shirt that says, I have unpaid taxes. When suddenly you hear a booming voice from the door. Halt, tax evader! You turn around, expecting to see Polly with her sexy vest and pocket calculator, but it's actually a grizzled Tyrannosaurus in a business suit from the Department of Monstrous Revenue. As you flee the scene, you see Polly about to put on a lab coat and goggles.
Hey, why are you running? Why are you wearing that shirt? Oh, did you think it was actually going to be a sexy tax attorney? I was super high when I said that. I said a sexy chemist.
You're going to need a regular chemist after the beating that Tyrannosaurus gave you. You lose 2 money and 1 boldness.
Damn it!
Aww. Blue. You're my boy, Blue.
Beach. So I'm pretty sure. So auditorium is creativity.
Okay.
Class is smarts. I believe.
Bathroom's boldness, apparently.
Bathroom's boldness. The outdoors is like fun.
Okay.
And I believe the library is money.
Yeah, because that's where you want to be. That day, while rehearsing for the class play, it's as though the muses themselves have descended to give you figurative oral sex. Your performance is intense and inspiring. It will be remembered for generations, which is pretty rad by high school play standards. You gain 2 creativity.
Pervert. Oh, good.
Oh, good, it's you. Hey, you're Princess Daisy.
Sigh. Woe is me. Sigh.
Could Miranda possibly be doing this because she wants attention? Only one way to find out.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. As I was standing here, suffering
gallantly
in silence.
She did, and she wasn't, but okay.
I had the most tragic injustice befall me earlier this morn. I was rejected from our school's water polo team. They claimed I was mistaken about how polo is conducted underwater. Excuse me, but I was raised underwater. How is one even supposed to play water polo without heavily armed seahorses as a mount? How, I ask you? Perhaps I offended them when I implied they were too
impoverished
to afford sea steeds. If so, why would I love to make more
reparations?
But it may be too soon for me to show my face. Would you be so kind as to take them the gift of this omelet to be
to begin sure, the healing.
I'm told that peasants consider eggs to be a delicacy.
Hmm, obviously. And what would make the gesture even better is the personal touch of...
toppings.
Caviar eel.
Chocolate-covered
sand crabs.
They'll never forget this was a present from our mer princess. An elegant stenciled card with your sincerest apologies, a list of all their fears, and bundled of compromised photographs? Ooh.
Yes, blackmail them with the card. I like that.
I like that one.
But you did the chocolate-covered foods and stuff.
Yeah, well, that would be me. I would just be like,
here's more food. There's some food on
there. Make these foods better.
Yeah. Why, yes, of course. Chocolate-covered sand crabs, the food of my people. Nothing says fit for a mermaid princess like a breakfast of seafood. As we say in my kingdom, wake up and smell the slowly rotting whale carcasses, then come have a bite before we head off to the day's executions. I'm sure you have similar saying here. Thank you so much for your service, my hero. Godspeed to you and your seafood-filled omelet. And make sure to take lots of pictures of them eating the eggs so we can all remember how generous I was.
Sweet. I mean, less sweet in that you now have to carry eggs filled with dead fish across the campus to the Water Polo Club's headquarters.
Delicious.
But you did see how happy Miranda looked. Happy as a clam who wasn't baked into an omelet. You gained 2 charms and plus 1 creativity.
Yeah, my creativity's off the roof.
Green, go here.
Are you super green?
I'm super green.
Super green.
I need brains.
Aww.
That day, you listen to your elders and learn valuable lessons. Sometimes, after all the monster nonsense and the dating gimmicks, you forgot that attending class is supposed to be the primary activity at this high school. You gain 2 smarts.
Nicely done.
I need more creativity. Shit, my creativity's low. My fun is super low, too. Later, you come across Damien and Vera in the hallway, nonchalantly holding a locker shut with all their strength. The locker has a sign on it that says, "Nothing to see here," and is screaming.
Shut the hell up, you!
Adorable, fluffy, little... Fluffy? You see, we're spending quality time with our new pet. Isn't that right, Damien? From somewhere in the locker, you hear, "My parents will pay anything," before Damien kicks the door.
Yeah, that's right. Affordable, quiet... Fluffy, who's going to stay quiet if he knows what's good for him.
You know, I don't have a great track record with pets. I had some mice for half a day, but my hair ate all of them.
It sure would be a shame if our new pet died before we receive the true joy of pet ownership.
Yes, exactly. The sweet, sweet bank account filling, filthy rich making joy of pet ownership. Surely you have lots of knowledge about pet care. Why not share some of it? You know what pets love? Hardcore death metal all the time to drown out their noises. If you love something, set it free. Just implant a tracking device first.
Go with your first.
Yes,
knowledge.
Great.
Perfect.
Not so fun. Great. Let's crank that shit! Damien pulls out his iBanshee and blasts his favorite sludgecore anthem, Every Swear I Know, explicit version.
Yeah!
Perfect. This is precisely what we need in order to make sure we don't blow our cover. At that moment, Crazy Martin, the werebear janitor, rushes down the hall towards the 3 of you, bellowing wildly and waving his paws.
Fuck. Dick.
What is blasting profanity-filled music class disrupting decibels against the rules? This school is so strict. Crazy Martin, the werebear janitor, hauls all of your asses to detention where there's no music to be heard. God damn it, I'm bad at this.
But you got his attention.
I know. Sands of scrubbing ectoplasm out of the toilets. I lose 2 smarts. I just got the smarts! My fun is dead. I'm dead.
You are not fun.
I am not a fun person.
R.I.P. Oh, this is cool too.